أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
الله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا صاحبي السجن يا أرباب متفرقون خير أم الله الواحد القهار. ما تعبدون من دونه إلا أسماء سميتموها أنتم وآباؤكم ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان. إن الحكم إلا لله أمر أن لا تعبدوا إلا إياه ذلك الدين القيم ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. We were reading the ayat through which Prophet Yusuf alayhi salatu was salam was preaching to his fellow prisoners. Ya sahib al-sijn, O two of my prisoners, co-prisoners, amma ahadukuma fayasqi rabbahu khamra. As for one of you who saw that he was pressing wine in his vision, the interpretation which Yusuf told him, that you will be freed and you will again be restored to your position and you will be pouring out the wine to your lord, to your king. Now here, Rabb for king. Wamal akhar, the other one who said that I saw, you know, myself carrying some bread on my head and the birds were eating from it. Wamal akhar, to him he said, he will be fayuslabu, he will be crucified, fatakulu tayru min rasihi, and the birds will be eating from his head. قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ الَّذِي فِيهِ تَسْتَفْتِيَانِ. This is the decision of the matter about which you wanted to have inquiry and you wanted to have the opinion. وَقَالَ لِلَّذِي ظَنَّ أَنَّهُ نَاجٍ مِنْهُمَا. And he asked the one about whom he had thought that he will be freed and he will be saved. اُذْكُرْنِي عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ. You just remember me and mention me in the presence of your Lord, the King. Tell him that a person is there in the prison, innocent, he has done nothing. He is there, a prisoner. فَانْسَاهُ الشَّيْطَانُ ذِكْرَ رَبِّهِ. But Satan made him forget. And he didn't remember that Yusuf had said to him that he should mention him to his king. فَلَّبِسَ فِي السِّجْنِ بِضْعَ سِنِينَ. So he remained in the prison for a number of years. Now these number of years are said to be 10. When he came out from the prison, he was 30. He was 17, they say, when he was thrown in the well. And then he was taken to Egypt. He remained 3 years at the house of Al-Aziz, the chief executive officer in that government. Then he was imprisoned and remained in prison for 10 years. So when he came out, he was 30. وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ إِنِّي أَرَى سَبْعَ بَقَرَاتٍ. Now this is after about 10 years what is going to happen. Now between these two ayat, you know, there is a gap of 10 years regarding the dates of the incidents. قَالَ الْمَلِكُ. The king said, now who was this king? First thing that is to be noted is that he is not Fir'aun. Faraina was the title of the kings who belonged to the soil of Egypt, the local nation. You know, the people, they were having their own system and they were having their own kings, and they were called Fir'aun. But actually this king was of the Amalekites, Amalaka. They were from the Arabian desert. They had invaded Egypt and they were governing Egypt at that time. And he was a Semitic in his origin. The Egyptians are said to be the progeny of Hazrat Ham, the second son or the third son of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, not Sam. But you know, people of the Arabian desert and of Iraq and Sham, they were the progeny of Hazrat Sam, Semitics. So they were Semitics, they had invaded Egypt and they were ruling there. So as if they were the alien rulers. And that is why they are not called, you know, they are not called Pharaoh. And they say that his name was, they are called Hyksos kings, and the name of this king was Apophis. And his, you know, his capital was Memphis. وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ إِنِّي أَرَى سَبْعَ بَقَرَاتٍ سِمَانٍ. And the king said to his chieftains in his court, I am seeing إِنِّي أَرَى. And this means, you know, he saw this vision repeatedly. سَبْعَ بَقَرَاتٍ سِمَانٍ. I see seven cows, fat ones. يَاكُلْهُنَّ سَبْعُنِ جَافٌ. And they are swallowed and devoured by seven who are very lean. وَسَبْعَ سُنْبُلَاتٍ خُضْرٍ. And I see in my vision 7 ears of corn which are green. وَأُخَرَ يَابِسَاتٍ. And another 7 which are dry. يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ أُوتُونِي فِي رُؤْيَايَ أَفْتُونِي فِي رُؤْيَايَ. Oh, my chiefs, now tell me about my vision. إِن كُنْتُمْ لِرُؤْيَايَ تَعْتَابُرُونَ. If you are the interpreters, if you know the expounding of the visions. قَالُوا أَزْغَاثُ أَحْلَامٍ وَمَا نَحْنُ بِتَعْوِيلِ الْأَحْلَامِ بِعَالِمِينَ. They said they seem to be mixed up false dreams. And we don't know the interpretation and expounding of this type of dreams which are mixed up, have no reality behind them. وَقَالَ الَّذِي نَجَى مِنْهُمَا. Now that person, the two prisoners, and the one who was freed and he was now serving the king, you know, he was to pour the wine in the cup of the king. وَقَالَ الَّذِي نَجَى مِنْهُمَا وَذَّكَرَ بَعْدَ أُمَّتِينَ. And now he recalled after this long period of time, oh, Yusuf was there and I asked the interpretation of my dream and he could tell it. And then he has told me that I should mention about him in the presence of the king. وَذَّكَرَ بَعْدَ أُمَّتِينَ أَنَا أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِتَعْوِيلِهِ فَأَرْسِلُونَ. I will be able to tell the meanings and the interpretations or the expounding of this vision. So you send me forth to Yusuf in the prison. Now when he has reached the prison, he says, Yusuf, O Yusuf Siddiq, O Yusuf, the true one, as Yusuf Siddiq, aftina fi sab'i baqaratin. Now give us your verdict in the vision of 7 cows, simanin, who are fat. Yaakuluhunna, they are being devoured or eaten up, swallowed, sab'un yajafun, by 7 cows who are lean. وَسَبْعِ سُنْبِلَاتٍ. And about 7 ears of corn, خُضْرٍ, which are green. وَأُخَرَ يَابِسَاتٍ. Another 7 which are dry. لَعَلِّي أَرْجِعُ إِلَى النَّاسِ. So that I may return to the people. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَعْلَمُوا. So that they can know what is the meaning and interpretation of this dream of the king. قَالَ تَزْرَعُونَ سَبْعَ سِنِينَ دَابًا. He said, Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam said, you will have normal harvest, usual harvest for 7 years. فَمَا حَسَّتُمْ فَذَرُوهُ فِي سُمْبُلِهِ. So whatever you reap, you keep it in the ears. Don't take them out. Don't take the corns out. This was the way to preserve it, you know. إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِمَّا تَعْكُلُونَ. Except the little that you eat. Whatever you require, the daily rations, you take out from the ears. But the rest of it, let it be as it is. ثُمَّ يَعْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ سَبْعٌ شِدَادٌ. Then after that, 7 years will be of very hardship. يَاكُلْنَ مَا قَدَّمْتُمْ لَهُنَّ. Those 7 years will eat up what you had stored for them. You will be storing for 7 years. The excess crop will be stored. Keep on storing them. And now when you know there will be draft for 7 years, you will eat up the stored grains. Now, إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِمَّا تُوْسَدُونَ. Except a little amount of it which you will have to preserve for the next crop, as to use it as seeds for the next crop. ثُمَّ يَعْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ. Then again, after those 7 years, the year will come, فِيهِ يُغَاسُ النَّاسِ, in which the people will have rains, وَفِيهِ يَعْسِرُونَ. And in that year, they will be pressing wine, you know. There will be crop and there will be greenery and everything will be okay and you will be pressing wine. But God, now he came to the court, he told the interpretation of the vision to the king. وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ أُتُونِي بِهِ. Now he said, bring that person to me. He seems to be very wise. فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُ الرَّسُولُ. But when, you know, the messenger from the king came to Yusuf, قَالَ ارْجِعْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ. He said, go back to your king, to your master, to your lord. فَاسْأَلْهُ. And ask him, مَا بَالُ النِّسْوَةِ اللَّاتِ قَطَّعْنَ أَيْدِيَهُنَّ. What about the women who cut their hands? I was blamed for that. I was imprisoned for that, without the charge being proved against me. But at least that was said, you know, to be the case. So unless I am, you know, absolved, and, you know, I am honorably acquitted of that charge, I am not ready to get out of this prison. إِنَّ رَبِّي بِكَيْدِهِنَّ عَلِيمٌ. Verily, my Lord knows about their machinations, whatever they did. I didn't do anything wrong. قَالَ مَا خَطْبُكُنَّ. Now the king gathered all of them. And he asked them, مَا خَطْبُكُنَّ إِذْ رَاوَدْتُنَّ يُوسُفَ عَنْ نَفْسِهِ. What was the matter with you when you solicited and you wanted to and tried to seduce Yusuf? قُلْنَ هَاشَا لِلَّهِ. They said, by Allah, be blameless. مَا عَلِمْنَا عَلَيْهِ مِنْ سُوءٍ. We don't know, we have no knowledge of anything evil about him. قَالَتْ اِمْرَأَةُ الْعَزِيزِ. And now, the wife of that chief minister or the chief executive officer, he spoke out. الْآنَ حَسْحَسَ الْحَقِّ. Now that the truth has come out. أَنَا رَاوَدْتُهُ عَنْ نَفْسِي. I confess that I was trying to seduce him. وَإِنَّهُ لَمِنَ الصَّادِقِينَ. And he is absolutely, he is true, he was not a sinner. ذَلِكَ لِيَعْلَمَ أَنِّي لَمْ أَخُنْهُ بِالْغَيْبِ. Now about these two ayat, following two ayat, there's very difference of opinion as to who said these words. You know, the continuity of the of this, you know, text, that demands that these are also the sayings of the same woman. But people usually think that these, you know, things, these words appear to be coming from a very knowledgeable and a person who believes in Allah and everything, you know. And that woman was not of that character or that level or that stature. And these words, you know, they are befitting only for Yusuf, alayhi salatu wasalam. So one way of interpretation is that Hazrat Yusuf said that I didn't want to expose these women, but I did want that, you know, I should be honorably acquitted. ذَلِكَ لِيَعْلَمَ أَنِّي لَمْ أَخُنُ بِالْغَيْبِ. So that he knows, he should come to know who, the Al-Aziz, the husband of that woman should come to know that I didn't betrayed him and betrayed his trust in his absence. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْكَيْدَ الْخَائِنِينَ. And I very well know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to make the guile of the betrayer successful. وَمَا أُبَرِّئُ نَفْسِي. At the same time, I don't declare my soul to be sinless and that it is all free from anything low. إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ سُوءٌ. Verily, the animal self in man commands him to something evil. إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِسُوءٍ. From here, you know, we derive the word نَفْسَ أَمَّارَةٌ. And that is not the self, the higher self. We have two selves within us, the spiritual self and the animal self, the animal soul and the divine spirit. These are two different things. We have a composite existence. So now the baser self, as we call it, or in Freudian terminology, the id or libido, well, all these lusts and desires, sensual gratification, they emerge from that baser self. So I don't absolve myself, because the baser self in every human being urges him for something evil. إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبِّي. Except the one whom the Lord has, you know, shown mercy. إِنَّ رَبِّي غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Verily, my Lord is forgiving and merciful. Now these words, you know, they are befitting to Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. But some of the exegetes, they, because, you know, the continuity of the text that demands that these words are of wife of Al-Aziz. Maybe that during these 10 years, she might have been transformed. And she might have, you know, reformed herself. And this seems to be, most of the people believe in it, that although she had all the evil designs before that, but now 10 years had passed. And during this period might be that she had, you know, she had made Tawbah, repented, reformed her, and she had become such a, to attain such level of knowledge. Maybe, we can't say. وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ أُوتُونِي. Now this is to what I was referring by the context. Now the proceedings of the court are going on. And Hazrat Yusuf has not as yet come to the court according to the sequence of these ayat. وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ أُوتُونِي بِهِ. Now when all this thing was cleared in the absence of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam in the court of the king, he said, oh, bring him to me. أَسْتَخْلِصُ لِنَفْسِي. I will reserve him for myself. Such a noble man, such a person, such a man of such a high character. I will keep him with me exclusively. فَلَمَّا كَلَّمَهُ. And when he came and they had a dialogue, قَالَ إِنَّكَ الْيَوْمَ لَدَيْنَا مَكِينٌ أَمِينٌ. The king said, oh Yusuf, from this day you will be high in rank near us and a fully trusted person. You will hold a very high position in my court. قَالَ اجْعَلْنِي عَلَىٰ خَزَائِنِ الْأَرْضِ. Because Hazrat Yusuf now had the knowledge what is going to happen, what catastrophe is going to come to this land. So he said, قَالَ اجْعَلْنِي عَلَىٰ خَزَائِنِ الْأَرْضِ. Now put me in charge of all these storehouses of the land. إِنِّي حَفِيظٌ عَلِيمٌ. I am the best keeper. And I am a knowledgeable person. I know how to manage things, and I will do it, inshallah. So he knew it. And from here, you know, some of the ulama, they deduce that if a person knows that he can deliver the goods, he can present himself, offer himself for some office. Generally, it is believed that nobody should offer himself for an office, because to aspire for office is not good. It is really not good. If you are aspiring for any office or any position for your own sake. But if your intentions are that you know the problem which is going to be faced, you have the know-how and the expertise, and you can, you know, deliver the goods, then you shouldn't keep back, you know, and you should offer yourself. So this is the place from where those ulama, they take the argument and they infer. Because he said, اجعلني على خزائن الأرض. Now place me in charge and authority over all the storehouses of the land. Inni hafizun alim. وَكَذَلِكَ مَكَّنَّا لِيُوسُفَ. In this way, we establish Yusuf in the land. يَتَبَوَّوْ مِنْهَا حَيْسَ يَشَاءَ. Enjoying authority as when and where he liked. نُصِيبُ بِرَحْمَةِنَا مَنْ نَشَاءَ. We bestow our mercy on whomsoever we like. وَلَا نُزِيُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسَنِينَ. And we are never going to let the reward or recompense of the good doers go in waste. وَالْأَجْرُ الْآخِرَةِ أَكْبَرُ. وَالْأَجْرُ الْآخِرَةِ خَيْرُ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَكَانُوا يَتَّقُونَ. And surely the recompense or reward of the Akhirah, of the hereafter, is much better for those who believe and who have been fearing Allah, who have been having proper regard for him. Now another 8 to 10 years have passed between these two ayat, 57 and 58. Now again a pause of about 10 years or 9 years or 8 years at least. Then you know, 7 years went okay, normal harvest, whatever was being reaped, most of it was taken into the storehouses, stored. Except the, you know, rationing given to the people, the lesser, the better. Now the famine starts, and it is the 8th year now when the famine starts, and it is proved in history. It was a very widespread famine. It affected not only the Egypt, but the adjoining areas of Palestine and Syria. And now Hazrat Yaqub, along with his 11 sons, he was residing in Palestine. And here Yusuf was in Egypt. But the drought was so severe and the famine was so widespread that this affliction came to them also. But they came to learn that, well, in Egypt there is a king, and he, you know, has a minister or someone who manages the things, and he is kind enough, and he can give grain and, you know, foodstuffs to other people also. So they used to come and get, you know, from there some grain. وجاء إخوة يوسف. Now the brothers of Yusuf came. فدخلوا عليه. They presented him before Yusuf عليه الصلاة والسلام. Who are you? This is our land. And this grain we have stored for ourselves. How come you don't deserve it? So because it was an unusual thing, so they had to be presented that there some people have come from far away and they want, you know, that some grains should be issued to them. فَعَرَفَهُمْ. He recognized them. Oh, they are my brothers. فَهُمْ لَهُ مُنْكِرُونَ. But they couldn't recognize him. وَلَمَّا جَهَّدَهُمْ بِجَهَادِهِمْ. And when he had provided them with the provisions, قَالَوْتُونِي بِأَخِلْ لَكُمْ. Now they were 10. Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salam had not let Binyamin go with them. It seems that for every family, some measure fixed. This much amount, this much weight will be allowed as a ration for 1 year for each family. So now 10 of them, they came and they said, another family, another brother who is there behind, you know, he has not come with us. He said, okay, but this time when you come, you bring that brother also. وَلَمَّا جَهَّدَهُمْ بِجَهَادِهِمْ قَالُوْتُونِي بِأَخِلْ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَبِيكُمْ. Bring to me the brother you have from your father, not your mother's, but your father. أَلَا تَرَوْنَ أَنِّي أُوفِ الْكَيْلِ. Don't you see that I fill the mayor. وَأَنَا خَيْرُ الْمُنْزَرِينَ. I am the best of the horse. فَإِلَمْ تَعْتُونِي بِهِ. If you don't bring him to me, فَلَا كَيْلَ لَكُمْ مِنْدِي. Then you won't find any mayor of these grains with me. وَلَا تَقْرَبُونَ. And don't approach me. Don't come to me at all. قَالُوا سَنُرَاوِدُ عَنْهُ أَبَاهُ وَإِنَّا لَفَاعِلُونَ. They said, we shall try to entice our father. Now he has become very careful about Binyamin because what had happened to Yusuf, you know, so he was over careful now. But we'll try to entice him and we'll do it. Inshallah, we shall be able to do it. وَقَالَ لِفِتْيَانِهِ جَلُولُ بَزَاعَتَهُمْ فِي رِحَالِهِمْ. And he, that is Yusuf, said to his boys, you know, فِتْيَانِهِ, who were working, mayoring and giving, you know, rations, distributing, he said, put their merchandise in their own saddle bags. Now, what price they could offer? People of the desert, coming from the desert, might be some skins of animals, some wool, something of this sort. They had brought it to pay as a price. So he said, okay, whatever they had brought, put them back, put these things in their saddle bags. So that, فِي رِحَالِهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَعْرِفُونَهَا إِذَا انْقَلَبُوا إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِمْ. So that when they go back to their families, they remember it and they recognize it. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. So that they will come again, that he was so gracious to us. He gave us the ration and the grains and then, you know, he returned to us our merchandise. فَلَمَّا رَجَعُوا إِلَىٰ أَبِيهِمْ قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا. When they returned back to their father, Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam, قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا. They said, oh, our father, مُنِعَ مِنَّ الْكَيْلِ. One mayor has been denied to us because he said, if you have another brother, bring him here. Then only I will give, you know, his part, his portion of the ration. فَأَرْسِلْ مَعَنَا أَخَانَا. So please send with us our brother, Binyamin. نَقْتَلْ. We shall have another mayor. وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. And we shall protect him fully. قَالَ هَلْ آمَنُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ إِلَّا كَمَا آمِنْتُكُمْ عَلَىٰ أَخِيهِ. He said, should I entrust you to him, entrust him to you, just as I entrusted his brother to you before? فَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ حَافِظًا. Allah is the best protector. وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. The most merciful of all the mercifuls. فَلَمَّا فَتَحُوا مَتَاعَهُ. And now when they opened their, you know, goods, وَجَدُوا بِزَاعَتَهُمْ رُدَّةٍ. And they found their merchandise returned to them. قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا مَا نَرْغِي. Now again they said, oh, our father, what can we desire more? هَذِهِ بِذَاعَتُنَا رُدَّةِ لَيْنَا. Our own merchandise has been returned to us. وَنَمِيرُ أَهْلَنَا وَنَحْفَظُ أَخَانَا. And we shall get provision for our family and guard our brother. وَنَسْدَادُ كَيْلَ بَعِيرٍ. And shall get an extra mayor of a camel's load. ذَلِكَ كَيْلٌ يَسِيرٌ. And this is a very easy thing to get, this may another mayor. So send, please send our brother with us. قَالَ لَنْ أُرْسِلَهُ مَعَكُمْ. He said, no, I'm not at all going to send him with you. حَتَّى تُوْتُونِ مُوْسِقًا مِّنَ اللَّهِ. until you have a solemn pledge by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَتَعْتُنَّنِي بِهِ, that you will definitely bring him back to me. إِلَّا يُحَاتَ بِكُمْ, except that you are all rendered helpless, you are all encircled, then it is something else. But never come to me without him. And you have to give me this solemn pledge. فَلَمَّا آتَوْهُ مَوْسِقَهُمْ, when they gave him his solemn pledge, قَالَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ مَا نَقُولُ وَكِيلٌ, then they said, then he said, okay, now Allah is the witness and guardian over what we are saying. This is an agreement. وَقَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ, يَا بَنِيَّ, and he said, oh my sons, لَا تَدْخُلُوا مِنْ بَابٍ وَاحِدٍ, don't enter that city from one gate, because people will say, 11 are coming. So actually, maybe they feel some jealousy in their minds, 11 brothers together. So, وَدْخُلُوا مِنْ أَبْوَابٍ مُتَفَرَّقَةٍ, so you enter the town different from different gates, two from this, three from this, so that you don't appear to be a big, you know, group. وَمَا أَغْنِي أَنْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, I cannot save you from Allah anything. إِنِ الْحُكْمُ إِلَّا لِلَّهِ, all authority is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ, on him I have placed all my trust and faith. وَعَلَيْهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ, and surely on him should all the believers and all those who have, who want to put any trust, in him should they put their trust. وَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا مِنْ هَيْسُ أَمَرَهُمْ أَبُوهُمْ, and when they entered from where their father had asked them to enter, مَا كَانَ يُغْنِي عَنْهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, Yaqub couldn't save them from Allah anything. إِلَّا حَاجَةً فِي نَفْسِ يَعْقُوبَ قَضَاهَا, except that it was only a craving in Yaqub's heart and he satisfied it. وَإِنَّهُ لَذُو عِلْمٍ لِمَا عَلَّمْنَاهُ, and he knew all the knowledge which we had given to him. The knowledge which we gave, he had it. The knowledge which we didn't give, didn't have it. So it appears that the knowledge which was given was that Yusuf is alive and he will return to you. But the knowledge which was not given, where he is, he didn't know. And that was, you know, very going to be very hard for him for so many long years. And if you feel, and if you know that your son has died, you have buried him, you know, after some days, you know, you have the patience and you just forget. But knowing he is living, but not knowing where he is, in what conditions he is. Maybe he is a slave, maybe he is being, you know, put to hardships. So these things, you know, they were bothering Hazrat Yaqub alayhi salatu wasalam very much. And due to this grief and sorrow, you know, he had lost his eyesight. He had become blind, practically blind, weeping and weeping and weeping. Because he knew he is alive. But where he is, and in what condition he is, don't know. إِنَّهُ لَذُو عِلْمٍ لِمَا عَلَّمْنَاهُ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, but most of the people don't know. وَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا عَلَىٰ يُوسُفَ آوَىٰ إِلَيْهِ أَخَاهُ, and when they entered on Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he called his brother to him privately. قَالَ إِنِّي أَنَا أَخُوكُ, and he said, I am your brother. فَلَا تَبْتَئِسْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ, now don't remain disheartened with what they have been doing. Those days are now gone, because you know they must have been doing bad to this to Binyamin also, the character that they had. So he said, okay, I am your brother and you will stay with me, and now your days of suffering are gone. فَلَمَّا جَهَّدَهُ بِجَهَادِهِمْ, now we, then when he has provided them with the provisions, جَعَلَ السِّقَايَةَ فِي رَحْلِ أَخِيهِ, Yusuf himself placed the drinking cup in his brother's saddlebag. Now the caravan was to depart, all the 11 brothers had to go, but Yusuf had placed himself, you know, a cup, and must be of gold. It was king's drinking cup, you know, he put it in the saddlebag of Benjamin. ثُمَّ أَذْنَ مُؤَذِّنٌ, now the servants there, the boys working there, they didn't know. But any one of them, he cried out, أَيُّتُ حَلِيرُ إِنَّكُمْ لَسَارِقُونَ, O cameliers, O people of the camels, you are thieves. قَالُوا وَأَقْبَلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ مَعْذَا تَفْقِدُونَ, and they said, turning to them, What are you missing? قَالُوا لَفْتِنُوا سُوَعَ الْمَلِكِ They said, we are missing the drinking cup of the king. وَلِمَنْ جَاءَ بِهِ حِمْلُ بَعِيرٍ Whosoever brings it back, well, we shall be punished. So actually, whosoever can bring us back, for him, حِمْلُ بَعِيرٍ Another camel load of grain would be granted. وَأَنَا بِهِ زَعِيمٍ And I am responsible. I take the responsibility. قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ عَلِمْتُمْ مَا جَئِنَا لِنُفْسِدَ فِي الْأَرْضِ They said, By Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you very well know that we have not come here to make mischief in the land. وَمَا كُنَّا سَارِقِينَ And we are not thieves. We have come here to get the grains. How can we be thieves? قَالُوا فَمَا جَزَاهُ إِن كُنْتُمْ كَاذِبِينَ They said, then what should be the punishment of the person if you are telling lie? قَالُوا جَزَاهُ مَنْ وُجِدَ فِي رَحْلِهِ فَهُوَ جَزَاهُ They themselves said, okay, the person in whose sack this cup, drinking cup can be found, he himself will be the exchange of it. You can keep that person with you as a slave. كَذَلِكَ نَجِّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ And this is our method of punishing the thieves, the evildoers. فَبَدَى بِأَوْعِيَتِهِمْ قَبْلَ وِعَيَ أَخِيهِمْ Now Hazrat Yusuf والسلام, began searching their sacks. And he searched the sacks of other brothers before the sack of his own brother, his real total brother, his Aini brother, Binyamin. ثُمَّ اسْتَخْرَجَهَا مِنْ وِعَيَ أَخِيهِ Then he took it out from the sack of his brother. كَذَلِكَ كِتْنَا لِيُوسُفَ Now this is an apology from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yusuf didn't do it on his own. It would have been sort of, you know, deceiving people. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him the permission. He had given him this way, shown him this way. And because this was, Allah knew, this is not going to do any harm to anybody. Even that this Binyamin, he will be saved of the torture, of the persecution of the brothers. He will remain here with the brother. He will be in comfort. And in the long run, Allah knew what beforehand what is going to happen. It will be not harmful for anybody. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, He commanded Yusuf to do this. كَذَلِكَ كِدْنَا لِيُوسُفَ We contrived for Yusuf in this way. مَا كَانَ لِيَأْخُذَ أَخَاهُ فِي دِينِ الْمَلِكِ It was not possible for him to retain his brother according to the law of the king. This ayah is one of the most important ayat to understand the meaning, essence, essential meaning of deen. Deen il Malik. The system of governance in that land at that time was of monarchy. What is monarchy? One person holding the authority. Whatever he says becomes the law because he is sovereign. Now there was a law. Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam was occupying an authoritative position in that system, under that constitution. He was not himself the king. He was not the sovereign. Sovereign was the king who had seen that vision. And he had, you know, called back Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam from the prison and placed him at that position. He owed that position to the king. Now the laws were of the king, not of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam. So it was the system of governance in that country that was of monarchy. Now Deenul Malik, compare it with Deenullah. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحُ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا Deenul Malik, Deenullah. Deenul Awam, Deenul Malik, the system where sovereignty belongs to a person king. Deenul Awam, democracy. A system where sovereignty belongs to the masses, popular sovereignty. Deenullah, a whole system of life where sovereignty belongs to Allah. So these three words you must keep in mind. What is deen? Deen is a whole system of life under some sovereignty. Sovereignty can be of a person. Sovereignty can be of the nation. And sovereignty can be of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is deenullah. Islam is deenullah. Inna deena inda Allahi al-Islam. That is deenullah. And this is deenul jamhur. So to say, this is the deen of jamhur, the deen of the masses. Because they have, theoretically speaking at least, they have their sovereignty. مَا كَانَ لَيَاخُذْ أَخَاهُ فِي دِينِ الْمَلِكِ إِلَّا إِنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ Except if Allah commands. نرفع درجات من نشاء وی ریز ان رینک ہوم سو ایور وی لائک وفوق کل ذی علم علیم اینڈ اوور ایوری نالجیبل پرسن دیر از سم ون مور نالجیبل اینڈ ابو آل آل نوئنگ از اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی. نا وٹ واز دا ریئیکشن؟ دیز پیپل ہیڈ ناٹ ریفارم دم سیلز اپ ٹل ناؤ ایون یو نو آفٹر دی پیسج آف سو مچ ٹائم. قالوا ان یسرق فقد سرق اخ له من قبل. نا اف دس بنیامین ہیز کمیٹڈ اے تھیفٹ, اے برادر آف ہز ہیز آلسو ہیڈ آلسو کمیٹڈ تھیفٹ یو نو بفور, سو ہی واز دے ور بلیمنگ یو نو ان ایڈیشن ٹو بنیامین بلیمنگ یوسف ایون. فاسر رہا یوسف فی نفسہ سو بٹ یوسف کیپٹ اٹ ہڈن ان ہز ہارٹ, ہی ڈیڈنٹ ریٹارٹ, بٹ ہی سیڈ ان ہارٹ ولم یبدھا لہم, ہی ڈیڈنٹ سے سو اوپنلی ٹو دیم, ہی سیڈ سو ان ہز ہارٹ. قال التم شر مکانا, یو آر ورسٹ ان دی اسٹیٹس ان دی پوزیشن, واللہ عالم بما تصفون, اللہ ویری ویل نوز وٹ یو آر سیئنگ, یو آر ایبسولیوٹلی گیونگ اے فالس ایکوزیشن اگینسٹ می. No, I know that I never committed a theft. And you are saying that his brother also committed a theft. If he committed a theft, it's nothing, you know, unexpected. Because his brother also committed a theft. So they were still, you know, at that low level of meanness. قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزُ إِنَّ لَهُ أَبًا شَيْخًا كَبِيرًا. They said, oh, Aziz, he has a father and he is very old. شَيْخًا كَبِيرًا. فخذ احدنا مكانه, you keep any one of us in his place. انا نراك من المحسنين, we see you that you are a good doer, you behave with people gently, so please accept our request that you detain him. If he committed the theft according to what we said, he can be detained here, but please don't detain him. Any one of us you like, detain him. قال ما عاد الله ان ناخذ الا ما وجدنا متاعنا عنده انا اذا لظالمون. He said, well, we take refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we should seize a person, except one in whose sake we found our material, our property. If we do this, well, we shall be evil doers. He has done it by Allah's permission to retain Hazrat Ibn Yamin. فَلَمَّا اسْتَيْأَسُوا مِنْهُ, when they were disappointed from him that he is not going to let Bin Yamin go now, خَلَصُوا نَجِيَّا, now they conferred and they consulted each other privately. قَالَ كَبِيرُهُمْ, the eldest of them said, أَلَمْ تَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ أَبَاكُمْ قَدْ أَخَذَ عَلَيْكُمْ مَوْثِقًا مِنَ اللَّهِ. Don't you remember? Your father got from you a solemn pledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمِن قَبْلُ مَا فَرَّتُمْ فِي يُوسُفِ. And just remember what excesses you did to Yusuf before. He was, you know, the eldest and the kindest among them. He is the one who said, لَا تَقْتُلُوا يُوسُفَ. If you are bent upon doing something to him, well, throw him in some well so that he doesn't die. No, some caravan should come and take him out and take him away from you. If you are bent upon doing something, but don't kill him. And the same now, he is blaming them. مَا فَرَّتُمْ فِي يُوسُفَ فَلَنْ أَبْرَحَ اللَّهُ. I am not going to depart from this land. حَتَّى يَعْذَنَ لِي أَبِي. Until and unless my father gives me an express permission. أَوْ يَحْكُمَ اللَّهُ لِي. Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides something else for me. Maybe he sends death to me in this land, but I am not going to face my father without Binyamin. وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الْحَاكِمِينَ. And surely Allah is the best of the judges. اِرْجُوْ إِلَىٰ أَبِيكُمْ. Now you go back to your father. اِرْجُوْ إِلَىٰ أَبِيكُمْ فَقُولُوا يَا أَبَانَا. And tell him, oh, our father, إِنَّ أَبْنَكَ سَرَقْ. Verily, your son committed a theft. وَمَا شَهِدْنَا إِلَّا مَا عَلِمْنَا. And we can't give any testimony except what we have come to know. We can't say whether it is correct or wrong, but these are the facts of the case. وَمَا كُنَّا لِلْغَيْبِ حَافِظِينَ. But we are not guardians over the unseen. What has actually happened, we don't know. وَاسْأَلِ الْقَرْيَةَ الَّتِي كُنَّا فِيهَا. You can ask the town in which we were. وَالْعِيرَ الَّتِي أَقْبَلْنَا فِيهَا. You ask the caravan, the people in the caravan, with which we have returned, inna la sadiqun, we are, whatever we are saying is true. قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا. Hazrat Yaqub said the same verse. Your minds have enticed you to invent the matter. فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ. Again, I will have patience, and in a beautiful way. أَصَلَّ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَعْتِيَنِي بِهِمْ جَمِيعًا. This he knew. Yusuf is also alive. أَصَلَّ اللَّهُ, I hope. It's just possible that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings to me both of them together. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. Verily, he is all-knowing, all-wise. وَتَوَلَّ عَنْهُمْ, and he just turned away from them. وَقَالَ يَا سَفَى عَلَى يُوسُفُ. And he said, alas, oh my grief for Yusuf. Note here, again he is lamenting for Yusuf. Although the fresh, shock was for Binyamin, but the love for Hazrat Yusuf was so much, deep in the heart of Hazrat Yaqub, that even here he is mentioning Yusuf. يَا سَفَى عَلَى يُوسُفُ. وَبْيَضَّتْ عَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْحُزْنِ. And due to the grief, his eyes had become white. هُوَ كَزِيم. And he was, withholding and choking within him the grief. قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ تَفْتَأُ تَذْكُرُ يُوسُفُ حَتَّى تَكُونَ حَرَضًا أَوْ تَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُهْلِكِينَ. They said, by Allah, you will not cease remembering Yusuf till you become exhausted or you become dead. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أَشْكُو بَسِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. He said, I am complaining of my grief and sorrow only to Allah. I am saying nothing to you. Why do you stop me? إِنَّمَا أَشْكُو بَسِّي وَحُزْنِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَالَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. I know from Allah what you don't know. I know that Yusuf is alive. I know that he will come to me again. And that is why, I have all this grief. يَا بَنِيَّ اِذْهَبُوا فَتَحَسَّسُوا مِنْ يُوسُفَ وَأَخِيهِ. Oh my sons, go and search for Yusuf and his brother. وَلَا تَيَّسُوا مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ. Don't despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُ لَا يَيَّسُوا مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. Verily, only the people who disbelieve, they become despaired and disappointed from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَمَّا دَخَلُوا عَلَيْهِ قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزِ. Now it's a very pitiable position. Now when they came and they presented themselves to Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, قَالُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الْعَزِيزِ. They said, oh you Aziz, oh you powerful, oh you holding the authority. مَسَّنَا وَأَهْلَنَا الضُّرِّ. Affliction has touched us and our families. وَجَيْنَا بِبِزَاعَةٍ مُزْجَاةٍ. And we have brought the merchandise which is of scant worth, no value. Now we have been left with nothing. We can't present anything in exchange. Very little we have to offer as a price for this ration. فَأَوْفِ لَنَا الْكَيْلَ. But you please give us full measures. Don't look to what we have to offer. You please give us the full measures. وَتَصَدَّقَ لَنَا. And be charitable to us. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَجْزِي الْمُتَصَدِّقِينَ. Verily Allah rewards the one who makes charity. قَالَ هَلْ عَلِمْتُمْ. Now this was the time to disclose. He couldn't wait anymore. He couldn't see the plight of the brothers. They had gone so, low now. And the condition was so pitiable for Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam to bear anymore. So he disclosed himself. قَالَ هَلْ عَلِمْتُمْ مَا فَعَلْتُمْ بِيُوسُفَ وَأَخِيهِ إِذْ أَنْتُمْ جَاهِلُونَ. He said, do you recall or remember what you did to Yusuf and his brother when you were ignorant? As if they were not ignorant now. They were ignorant even now, but because, he was a gentle person, he didn't want to say that in the face of his brothers. قَالُوا أَيْنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُفْ. Now they say, oh, are you indeed Yusuf? قَالَ أَنَا يُوسُفْ وَهَذَا أَخِي. He said, yes, I'm Yusuf and he's my brother, Binyamin. قَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Our Lord has been very gracious upon me, us. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَيَسْبِرْ. Verily, whosoever has taqwa and regards, proper regard for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remains mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and shows perseverance. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَزِيُّ عَجْرَ الْمُحْسَنِينَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't let the reward of these muhsaneen go in waste. قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ آثَرَكَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا وَإِنْ كُنَّا لَخَاطِئِينَ. They said, by God, we swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has indeed chosen you above us. And this is the choice for prophethood. They were all sons of Yaqub. Someone has to be chosen. And you know, it was proved for all of them that actually Yusuf deserves to be chosen. And certainly we have been sinners. قَالَ لَا تَصْرِيبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْيَوْمِ He said, no, there's going to be no reproach upon you this day. يَغْفَرُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ I pray to Allah, He may forgive you. وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ And He is the most merciful of all the merciful. اِذْهَبُوا بِقَمِيسِ هَذَا Now take this shirt of mine and go with it. Take with you this shirt of mine. فَالْقُوهُ عَلَى وَجْهِ أَبِي And put it and cast it over the face of my father, يَاتِ بَصِيرًا His sight will return. وَاتُونِي بِأَهْلِكُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ And then you bring all your family and bring them to me here. Now they entered. مَا فَصَلَتِ الْعِيرِ Now when that caravan now left Egypt with that shirt of Hazrat Yusuf, قَالَ أَبُوهُمْ And now in Canaan, Hazrat Yaqub, their father said, إِنِّي لَأَجِدُ رُوِيحَ يُوسُفُ I find and I feel, I perceive the scent of Yusuf. لَوْلَا أَن تُفَنِّدُونَ Only if you don't think that I have been dementiated due to old age, you know. So I have gone crazy, dementiated. But you know, I am feeling and perceiving the scent of Yusuf. قَالُوا تَاللَّهِ إِنَّكَ لَفِي ذَلَالِكَ الْقَدِيمِ They said, oh, verily, by Allah, you are in your error, your old error. You think that he is alive. He has gone, you know, long away. فَلَمَّا أَنْ جَاءَ الْبَشِيرُ أَلْقَاهُ عَلَىٰ وَجْهِهِ فَارْتَدَّ بَصِيرًا Now when the bearer of the glad tiding came and he cast the shirt of Yusuf on his face, he became, you know, again seeing. قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ لَكُمْ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ He said, didn't I say to them that I know from Allah what you don't know? قَالُوا يَا أَبَانَا اسْتَغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا They said, oh, our father, now ask forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us, for our sins. إِنَّا كُنَّا قَاتِينَ Verily, we were the sinners. قَالَ صَوْفَ أَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ Now he is not صَوْفَ. No, he didn't ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala there and then, at the same time, immediately. He just promised, okay, after some time. صَوْفَ is for future. I will do it, okay. But you know, he was angry. So immediately he didn't ask the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So astaghfiru lakum rabbi. Okay. I will ask the forgiveness of my Lord for you. Innahu al-ghafur rahim. Verily, he is merciful and he is forgiving. Falamma dakhalu ala Yusuf awa ilayhi abawai. Now when all of them entered Egypt and when they presented themselves to Yusuf, he raised his parents, father and mother, to his throne. فَقَالَ ادْخُلُوا مِصْرَ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ آمِنِينَ And he welcomed them. Now enter Misr. If Allah so decrees, you will have peace here. You will have all rest. Security. Now note this also point of political importance. Because the king was not an Egyptian, alien king, so that was also advisable for him to have some alien force over there. So he actually welcomed and he settled them down in the best areas of Egypt. The best, the most fertile lands were given to them. Okay, come here, settle. So that he has a force, you know, if there is some rebellion, uprising among the locals, you know, then he can have a support. And that is why, you know, these people, Bani Israel, their progeny, they enjoyed the best of comforts. They were the most, you know, fortunate people. They had the best lands. And they had all the support of that, you know, king and his family. And that is why they were very prosperous. They multiplied in number. Udkhulu Misra inshaAllahu aminin. But there was, after a few hundred years, there was a local revolt, a revolution. Then the sons of the soil came up. Now for them, these people were the worst people because they had supported and they were a source of support for those alien rulers who were not Egyptians originally, who were alien rulers for Egyptians. وَرَفَعَ أَبَوَيْهِ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ وَقَرُّوا لَهُ سُجَّدًا And he raised his parents on the throne and they prostrated before, fallen, they fell before him in prostration. وقال يا ابت هذا تعبير رؤيا من قبل. And Yusuf said, oh my father, this is the ta'wil, this is the end, and this is the interpretation of my dream that I saw much earlier. قَدْ جَعَلَهَا رَبِّي حَقَّا. My Lord, my Rabb, has made it true. وَقَدْ أَحْسَنَ بِي إِذْ أَخْرَجَنِي مِنَ السِّجْنِ. And he was very gracious to me when he brought me forth from the prison. وَجَعَ بِكُمْ مِنَ الْبَذْ. And in the same way, it's very gracious that he has brought you from that desert. وَمِنْ بَعْدِ أَنْ نَزَغَ الشَّيْطَانُ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ إِخْوَتِي. After the Satan has inflicted a strife between me and my brothers. إِنَّ رَبِّي لَطِيفٌ لِمَا يَشَاءُ. My Lord is very subtle to whatever he commands and whatever he wants. Whatever he wants to accomplish, nobody can, obstruct him. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. Verily, he is the all-knowing, all-wise. رَبِّ قَدْ آتَيْتَنِي مِنَ الْمُلْكِ. Now he is praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh my Lord, you have given me this power to rule the land. وَعَلَّمْتَنِي مِنْ تَعْوِيلِ الْأَحَادِيثِ. And it is you who taught me the interpretation of all things, all sayings, all visions, all incidents, all accidents. فَاتِرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Oh, the originator of the heavens and the earth. أَنْتَ وَلِيِّي فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. You are my protector, even in this world and also in the hereafter. تَوَفَّنِي مُسْلِمًا. So please make me die as a Muslim. Protect me that I don't go away or go back from Islam and Iman. Keep me a Muslim till my death. وَعَلْهِقْنِي بِصَالِحِينَ. And then you join me with your righteous persons, bondsmen. ذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِي إِلَيْكَ. Now this is from the news of the unseen that we are relating to you. O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are revealing to you. وَمَا كُنْتَ لَدَيْهِمْ. You were not with them. إِذْ أَجْمَعُوا أَمْرَهُمْ. When they had decided and agreed upon their plot to put Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salam into the well. وَهُمْ يَمْكُرُونَ. And they were, plotting. وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. Although, for these people who asked this question, this should suffice. This should be sufficient for them to reveal to them that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. And all these news are coming to him from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It should be sufficient. وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. But even if you are very desirous, very keen, most of the people will not come to believe. وَمَا تَصَلُهُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ. And you are not asking for them any reward. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا ذِكْرٌ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. It is nothing but a reminding for all the worlds, all the nations of the world. وَكَأَيِّن مِنْ آيَةٍ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَمُرُّونَ عَلَيْهَا وَهُمْ عَنْهَا مُعْرِضُونَ. And how many signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His unity, His attributes are there in the heavens and the earth, and they pass over them, pass by them. وَهُمْ عَنْهَا مُعْرِضُونَ. But they don't ponder over them. They turn their faces away from that. وَمَا يُؤْمِنُ أَكْثَرُهُمْ بِاللَّهِ إِلَّا وَهُمْ مُشْرِكُونَ. Another very great, very important ayah. And most of them don't believe in Allah, except doing some sort of shirk also. This is applicable to us also. If we, peep down into our hearts and what beliefs we have, and to our, if we interpret, what our actions are, we'll find that we are also committing shirk. But only we have to know what shapes and what forms this shirk can take. What was the shirk of the ancient time? What is the shirk of the modern time? I have a 2 hours recording on this subject. The forms of shirk, different forms of shirk. أَفَأَمِنُوا أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ عَاشِرٌ مِنْ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ. Are these people secure that to them cannot come a covering from the chastisement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? أَوْ تَأْتِيَهُمْ السَّاعَةُ. Or to him the appointed hour, that qiyamah, might come baghtatan, suddenly. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. And they will not be perceiving it. They will not be apprehending it. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُو إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. Say to them, this is my way. I'm calling towards Allah, and I'm calling not blindly, with sure knowledge. This is most important. هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُو إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. Not only me, also who are following me. They are not following blindly. They are following knowingly. سبحان اللہ وما انا من المشرکین اینڈ آل گلوری از فار اللہ اینڈ آئی ایم ناٹ این ایسوسیٹڈ آئی ایم ناٹ فرام امنگ دی ایسوسیٹڈ آئی ڈونٹ ایسوسیٹ اینی ون اینی تھنگ ود اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی ان اینی ریسپیکٹ وما ارسلنا من قبلک الا رجالا نوحی الیہم من اہل القری اینڈ وی ڈنٹ سینڈ بفور یو ٹو آل دیز ٹاؤنز میسنجرز بٹ دے ور مین دے ور ہیومنز الم یسیروا فی الارض have they not moved in the earth, in the land, traveled in the land? فَيَنْظُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ and see for themselves what was the end of those who were before them. وَلَدَارُ الْآخِرَةِ خَيْرُ لِلَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا and surely the house of hereafter is much better, much better for those who have taqwa, who believe in Allah, who regard Him. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ so don't you understand? حَتَّى إِذَا اسْتَيْأَسَ الرُّسُلُ Until when the messengers got despaired. Despaired of what? Not of Allah's help. But that the nation is not going to believe anymore. No one else is going to believe now from among them. This is what you know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we have read it in Surah Uhud, that, O Nuh, nobody else is now going to believe in you, except those who have already believed. Hatta iza istayasa rusul, when the messengers of Allah became despaired of the people that they are not going to believe, وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ قَدْ كُذِبُوا And people also thought that they were told lies when they were told that a chastisement will come, a azab will come, you will be destroyed, and so many years have passed, no azab has come, and he thought also that all it was lie, it was false threats, nothing else. جَاءَهُمْ نَصْرُنَا Then our help came to them. To the messengers, فَنُجِّيَ مَنْ نَشَاءُ So whomsoever we please, he was saved. وَلَا يُرَدُّ بَأْسُنَا عَنِ الْقَوْمِ الْمُجْرِمِينَ And our chastisement could not be averted, our wrath could not be averted from the guilty. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصَهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ O you people of understanding, for you there is a lesson in their tales. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ خِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى This Quran is not something which could be forged by men. وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ It is the divine word and it confirms that is present before it. وَتَفْسِيرَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ And it has all the details for the guidance وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةً لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ And it is the guidance and the mercy of Allah for those who believe. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم
الله أكبر الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.